I am looking at skin, so look at the scalp. So I'm looking at human skin. So we're going to be looking at a different type of tissue here that's going to be an epithelial tissue. So if we start out, this is a good magnification where I can see pretty much everybody. This is a really good magnification. All the structures are pretty very evident here. If I'm going to go from the very, very top to this area right here, so if I go from here to here, what main layer would that be? Epidermis. If I go below this, till about right here, down here, what would I call that middle part of the skin? That's the dermis. And then the bottom layer of my skin would be the hypodermis. You could also call it the subcutaneous layer. Either one is actually going to be correct. Now, if we go back up and work our way back up to the top again, looking at some specific things, what kind of tissue do I find in the hypodermis? Find adipose tissue there. So that's adipose tissue. Now, here in the dermis, I find all kinds of different things, all different types of structures and glands and whatnots, okay, that we're going to find in the dermis. What do I call these guys right here? Guys, what are they? What do you say? I can't hear you, Stephanie. What is it? It is a sweat gland. Okay, eccrine sweat gland. So they are sweat glands. So yes, that is correct. What are these big guys right here? Those are oil glands. Correct. What is this whole structure right here? That is a hair follicle. What's inside of my hair follicle? A hair shaft. And then I've got these little tiny guys right here that are going to be associated with my hair follicles. There's one right there. He's pretty good. I mean, this is exactly what you want to see, is this guy right here. Who is this guy? A what?
The erector
pili muscle. Yes. The erector pili muscle is the muscle that's going to help make your hair stand on end. Now, if I look at my epidermis actually is going to be made up of many distinct layers, but we're only going to name two. The top layer here that is flaking off, what layer, a specific layer of the epidermis, what I call that? Subcutaneous layer down here. So what I call this? Stratum corneum, very good. And then down here at the very bottom, the layer that's going to be regrowing, the one that's actually going to be dividing and producing new cells, that very bottom layer is going to be my stratum basal. All right, any questions on the skin? No questions on skin? All right. All right, what is this? That is bone. Okay, so correct, that is bone. All right, so what do I call the little circular hole right in the center? That is a central canal, correct. What do I call all of this kind of background, this cream colored stuff in the background right here? That would be the
matrix.
So the non-living stuff, it's going to be my matrix, it's going to be my minerals, calcium, phosphorus, magnesium, all those minerals that we have. The hard calcified bone is the matrix. All right, who are the little dots? Those are my osteocytes in lacuna. And then who are the little wavy lines coming off my osteocytes? Those are called my canaliculi. All right, any questions? I think that's it. No, you are not. That is a comment. That's not a question. And no, you are not. Okay? All right. Any questions? I think I covered everybody. If I'm missing somebody, let me know. But because I do this in anatomy. And so in many cases, what I do is I'll do extra. Okay? So just make sure I'm hitting the minimum for you guys. And but I covered everybody. But I think I got everybody. This one you kind of have to go up on a little bit of a higher magnification for. But what is this tissue? This is hyaline cartilage, yes. What do I call all of this pinkish stuff in the background?
Matrix.
That's my matrix. And then what do I call these guys? These guys are chondrocytes and lacuna. Here's the little chondrocyte. You can see his nucleus. So there's the chondrocyte. You can actually see the little space here. It's actually going to be the lacuna. All right? Any questions? Okay. So there is that one. All right. Then there is this one. See everybody that I want to see in this image right here. So what am I looking at?
I'm looking at blood.
Who are these guys?
Erythrocytes.
You have to call them erythrocytes. You cannot call them red blood cells, okay? Kindergartners call them red blood cells. Okay, they're erythrocytes. Okay? What's the function of erythrocytes?
Transport oxygen.
Very good. What are these little guys? Thrombocytes. What do thrombocytes do? They're involved in blood clotting. And what are these guys? Leukocytes, and they are involved in immunity. Okay, immunity protection. So immunity. All right. So bone, hyaline cartilage, and blood are examples of connective tissue. Correct. All right. The skin. We had some epithelial tissue when we looked at that epidermis with that stratum corneum and the stratum basale. All right. So then we've got this kind of tissue is next. Main group of tissue do these guys belong to? It's nervous tissue. Okay, so this is nervous tissue. What are each one of these things? These are, they would represent a neuron. Okay, so they're going to represent our neurons, but remember our neurons can be divided up into multiple different parts. Specifically, what would I call this part of my neuron? That is a cell body, correct. What would be the short projections coming off of that cell body?
Dendrites.
Those are dendrites. Now, possibly, again, this part is a little tricky because it's hard to tell. Most likely, this guy right here who is coming off that's very long and very skinny, what would this guy be? He could be possibly the axon. So look, if they are short and stubby, they're going to be dendrites. If they're long and skinny, they're going to be axons. Okay? Mm-hmm. Any questions? Okay? Did you have to know the little cells in the background?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Making sure. So I do an anatomy. Okay. Any questions? All right. Nervous tissue. So then that's going to bring us to this guy, our last group of tissue. And then we have one more slide to look at. Or maybe not. Where is it? So what am I looking at?
Skeletal.
Very good. I'm looking at skeletal muscle. What do I call those bands that are alternating?
Striations.
Those are my striations. And who are these little guys? These would be my nuclei right here. They're pushing out toward the edge. They're bulging out to the edge just a little bit. There's one. There's another one. Here's one here and here. All right? So that's going to be my skeletal muscle. What kind of control is skeletal muscle under? It's under voluntary control. Okay, let's compare him to his cousin. And this is his cousin. Who is this cousin?
Cardiac.
Very good. It is cardiac muscle. All right, so in cardiac muscle, we can still see those bands. What are those bands? Striations. I want you to notice that the cells are not these long cylindrical cells anymore. Okay, they're going to be these highly branched cells that are going to come off and go in multiple directions. What do I call these guys? Who are these? They're going to be nuclei of the cells. And then we're going to see some thickened areas here. What would this thickened area right there be? That is an intercalated disc. All right, any questions? Okay, all right. So that is his cousin's skeletal muscle. Now his really distant cousin is going to be this guy. So So this is like your second or third cousin, maybe twice removed. Okay? Whereas skeletal muscle and cardiac muscle are going to be pretty close cousins. This guy is kind of like their distant cousin. Who is that? That is smooth muscle. These are the individual smooth muscle fibers. They have a centralized nucleus. It bulges right there in the center. What's missing from smooth muscle?
Striations.
Okay, so you're not going to find any striations. Now, this one is actually going to be what they call teased smooth muscle, the same way that we tease that skeletal muscle. We separated it all out so you can see the individual cells. But in its natural state, inside of hollow organs, this is what it's going to look like. So we had two slides of this right here. So here would be all of those smooth muscle cells compacted together before they were teased. If they were teased, they would have taken this and taken two fine little pointed needles and separated each individual cells out. This is the way smooth muscle looks inside of an organ. Okay, notice we're still missing those striations, correct? So you'll know that when you don't see striations, you are looking at what kind of muscle? You are looking at smooth muscle. And then you can see as they're squished and sandwiched, you have the individual nuclei right in there of each of those cells. You find it in hollow organs like your uterus, your urinary bladder, your GI tract. Okay, that's where you're going to find these things. Okay, any questions? All right, so the last slide is actually going to be development. So the development slide actually just goes through different stages that the egg and the zygote, those different kinds of things that you're going to see. All right, so this one is actually going to be just different stages to identify as we go through these guys. Okay, oh, perfect. That's what I want to see right there. All right, so basically I'm going to give you a progression here of everybody that you have to know. We're going to start off with that guy right there, front and center. Okay? That guy right there that you see, that is an unfertilized egg. I know that in my anatomy class. Again, I got to make sure I'm giving the right ones here because I'll say more or less depending upon which one. All right, so here we go. That little guy right there, front and center, this is an unfertilized egg. Here's how you know that it's an unfertilized egg. You can see a distinct nucleus, correct? So look, here's my nucleus right here. This is the nucleus of that cell. There's the nucleolus, right? So when you see that one cell right there with a very well-defined nucleus inside, you know that you're looking at an unfertilized egg. That would be what would be released from the female. We're looking at starfish in this case, but their development follows our pattern of development, so we can look at them for a direct comparison. Now I'm going to go right next door, pretty much. I think we can still see both of these guys in the image here. We can. This is my unfertilized egg. This is a fertilized egg. Question is, how do I know that it's a fertilized egg? Fertilized eggs don't have a nucleus. You don't see a nucleus in that cell up there, do you? No nucleus, okay? So when the sperm fertilizes that egg, we get fusion of the genetic material, and then that little zygote's gonna have to start to divide. Fertilized egg. Unfertilized egg, fertilized egg. In humans, about 18 to 24 hours after fertilization has taken place, that little zygote is going to divide. And it's going to divide into how many cells would you imagine? One cell will actually divide into two cells. So that is what we call the two-cell stage. So some of these names are pretty easy. This is the two-cell stage. After we divide into the two-cell stage, what stage do you think is coming next? The next would be the four-cell stage. And the four-cell stage. Did you see one before? There we go. Four-cell stage, correct? You can see as I tweak this guy here, I've got two on the bottom and two on the top. That's a good four cell stage. There's a two cell stage, there's a four cell stage. Well, what do you think is going to come next after the four cell stage? Ooh, there's a good four cell stage up here too, right there. Might be eight. Hard to tell. That might be eight. So if four is, what would come after four?
Eight.
Okay. So we want to find an eight cell stage, and it would appear that, let's find this an eight cell stage. There's this an eight cell stage right here. So I've got four. This is my eight cell stage right here. And then we go from 8 to 16 to 32 to 64. Eventually, we are going to be, make sure y'all don't have to do more, Rula, you do not. Eventually, what's going to happen is we are going to form this structure of cells that look like this ring right here. This guy right here is going to be the next stage. So we're going to keep dividing. We're going to become an we're going to be released as an unfertilized egg. We're fertilized, become a zygote. Become a two, a four, and an eight cell stage. We move on and we could pick out some of these, but it doesn't matter. As long as you can recognize two, four, and eight, I'm good. So most likely this is probably like an eight cell stage right here. This is the next stage. That is called the blastula. Now my blastula is going to, so this is my stage. The stage is called a blastula. So if I ask on the test what stage of development this is, you would say blastula. Inside my blastula is an open hollow space that's filled with fluid, and it would be called a blastocoele. Okay. Think of a water balloon. Okay. So a water balloon. The water balloon, the actual latex part of the balloon on the outside would be our cells. The inside would actually be the fluid. The water inside would be our blastocoele. So as this guy starts to divide and divide and divide and divide, he basically pushes all the cells out to the outer edges and becomes this hollow ball of cells. Think like a basketball, okay? Outside, we're going to have all the cells. Inside, we're going to have this space that's actually called the blastocoele. Now, from the blastocoele, we are going to take that little water balloon image, and we're going to poke inward. So we're going to take our finger on a water balloon, just like if you would take your finger on a water balloon, you would poke through, right? You can actually poke through, and if you don't pop it, you might actually get to the other side, correct? You kind of know what I'm talking about? So you can take your finger and poke through that filled water balloon. We're going to make the next stage, and that next stage is called the gastrula. So the next stage is actually going to be the gastrula. So again, I've got all kinds of stages on here. I can see all different kinds of things. I've got some unfertilized eggs over here. These would represent a cutaway version of that blastula. It looks a little bit different, which is a ring of cells, basically. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take that little ring of cells and we're going to start poking inward. We're going to get to this guy right here. Okay, and I have nothing to poke inward with. This is the gastrula right here. So the stage is called the gastrula. So we go from this thing called a blastula to a gastrula, and we start to poke that in. This little opening is something that we have talked about before. And this is the blastopore. So this is something that's going to kind of go back to blastopore when we talked about animals. Remember, the blastopore is going to become an opening, depending upon the way that you develop. If you're a protostome, that blastopore actually becomes the mouth, correct? If you're a deuterostome, it becomes the anus. This is a starfish. Starfish develop like us. This blastopore will become the anus. And as this pokes through to the other end, the opening on the other end will become the mouth. Got it? This is also where we start to develop those things called germ layers. And this should again be around the time that we talked about those animals. Ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm, correct? Right? Vaguely familiar, I hope? This is the ectoderm. Ectoderm is actually going to become the nervous system and the skin. This lining of the tissue that pokes in, this is the endoderm. And if you're the endoderm, you're going to become the lining of the GI tract. So remember, it's going to line the gut. This will actually poke through to the other side, and you'll end up kind of looking like this with two openings on the end. And this tissue right in here is actually going to become the lining of your gut, of your intestine. Your intestine, your mouth, your esophagus, your stomach, the entire digestive tract. All right? Any questions on that? Just kind of brings us back to some of the things that we talked about at the beginning of the semester. All right? So that covers all the slides. Any questions on the slides? All right, so what you have is you have all of the rest of the period to go back and review anything and everything that you need. All of the bones are out. Okay. All of the bones are out, and you can take the bones up if you wanted to, switch them up and quiz yourself. I've got muscles, I've got kidneys, I've got brains, I've got eyes, I've got hearts over here as well. So you can also get your rats out and you can review any of the guts that you want. So any of the guts, okay?